Unfortunately, more often than not, a colorist is only brought onto a project after production has wrapped and the film has been edited. At this point, the director and DP sit down with the colorist and start the process of look development. While this might seem like a totally fine workflow at first, there's good reason to do look development before even a single shot of the final project has been captured. You see, on set, when monitoring the camera image, you're always viewing it through some kind of a LUT. And if you haven't chosen one explicitly, it's more likely than not to be one provided by the manufacturer of the camera. And these LUTs always impart some kind of a look to the image. They have to, as there's an infinite number of ways to take the signal captured by the sensor and convert it to something that looks good on a display. Though what looks good depends very much on the project being shot. And as such, I'd say your best bet is to shoot some test shots as similar to the real thing as possible, including camera, lenses, wardrobe, locations and lighting, and then develop a show LUT based on that. But what exactly is a show LUT? Well, it combines two things, color management and the creative look. This results in a LUT that takes in the camera's log encoded image and outputs one suitable for displays with the creative look. But enough theory, let's see how to actually make a show LUT. First, we need a timeline with the test shots mentioned before, or at the very least something similar in the production camera's color space. And next, we can set up color management. I recommend doing it with notes to avoid any kind of confusion as to what is or isn't happening in your pipeline and what will or won't be baked into the final show LUT. If you're not familiar with node-based color management, you can catch up through this video. But the main thing is for your pipeline to expect an input in the camera's color space and output Rec 709 Gamma 2.4. Unless you want to monitor HDR, in which case you need different settings, but I won't be getting into that in this video. And then, when it comes to developing the actual look itself, that's quite an advanced topic, but you can get an idea of how I tend to do it here. Also, keep in mind that spatial operations, like blur, halation, and grain, cannot be baked into a LUT. I'd say the most important part is not shifting middle grey. At least unintentionally. This is because moving it will affect how the DP sets the overall exposure on set. You might have heard of exposing to the right. Well, this is simply exposing a brighter image and then bringing it down by using the show LUT, lowering the camera ISO, or doing it in the grade. By example, setting the HDR palette's global wheel to -1 stop. This results in less noise being visible in the image, though comes at the cost of lower dynamic range in the highlights. You can find out more on how to anchor middle grey in this video. Finally, once you have set up color management and have made a look you're happy with, we can export the show LUT. First, don't forget to turn off any shot-specific adjustments, such as primary corrections, and spatial operations in the look, such as halation or grain. Then right-click on the clip, choose Generate LUT, and 33-point cube. Now, everything that affects this clip grade-wise will be baked into a LUT, be it on the clip, group, or timeline level. Now, this .cube format we have exported is one of the most widely supported ones, on both cameras and monitors, though some cameras, like Arri Alexas, require a special LUT format, which this cube format can be converted into using Arri's own software. Congratulations, you have made yourself a show LUT that can be used both on set and brought into post-production to be given to editors and VFX artists if they are working on the log encoded image. You definitely don't want people getting used to, or worse, falling in love with the log encoded image itself, as it was never meant to be viewed as is. And if you're interested in learning more about LUTs and how they work, I can recommend watching this video. I'm Gaur, see you next time.